Trump recently wasted his time speaking at Trump Tower in New York as he somehow thinks he has a chance to turn the state red, which is one of the most delusional parts of his campaign. So I wanted to pull a few of these clips and see exactly what he was talking about.
I believe I will be able to make a deal between President Putin and President Zelensky quite quickly.
What does that look like?
I don't want to tell you what that looks like.
I mean, who even still falls for this nonsense? He failed us abroad last time. He ran as the deal maker, the businessman. This is what he'll do. And then he signed things like the USMCA deal, which hurt our labor and trade, got into a tariff war with China that raised our prices and sent us into a manufacturing recession before COVID, signed the Abraham Accords, which heightened tensions between Palestine and Israel, refused to stop sending weapons into Yemen, which directly enabled the Yemeni genocide. Like, what deal did this guy successfully make? Even domestically, he couldn't pass legislation with majorities in both the House and Senate, failing on every front except for his rich guy tax cuts. Remember the infrastructure he wanted to pass? Remember when he was going to repeal Obamacare and John McCain said, no, you don't? And then Biden came in and showed how easy it is passing multiple bipartisan bills, 7 pieces of legislation total, with a smaller Senate majority than Trump had.
We'll send a federal law enforcement large group of people, but a tough group of people, to liberate Aurora, Colorado. The governor of Colorado is petrified of these gangs. These are Venezuelan gangs with equipment better than our military has, going in with guns. The governor of Colorado is a coward.
There is so many things here that I almost don't even notice where to start. I would hope that nobody serious thinks that migrants have better equipment than our military. What he's talking about with the migrant gangs has been debunked anyway. But second, he's also literally just doing the Nazi thing. He's going to send a group of people in to walk the streets and liberate a town from a minority group of people he doesn't like. Does that sound familiar to anyone? Like Hitler? Like, you know, the Gestapo walking the streets of Nazi Germany and liberating it of the Jews? I mean, this is insane. He's literally talking about something that would cause mass chaos, having ICE or officers or the military, because he doesn't get specific, and having them walk the streets of a town, card checking brown people they think might be immigrants, walking into houses and checking for people. I mean, nobody sane hears this and thinks it'll lead to good outcomes, especially when these immigrants, mostly legal, benefit our economy massively. And it's, again, eerily similar to Hitler's plan against the Jews.
Nancy Pelosi should be prosecuted for that. And she should also be prosecuted for J6 because she turned down 10,000 or any number she wanted, soldiers or National Guard. And I hope you all read John Solomon and what John Solomon wrote 2 days ago.
I want to again just clarify this for the couple MAGA clowns I know always watch my videos, or even just those in the center who don't know, Democrats who maybe just haven't watched my videos where I've debunked this hundreds of times. Trump never formally requested troops. He casually commented about expecting a large crowd and there should be like 10,000 troops to someone in his administration, someone who didn't have the power to summon 10,000 troops. It was a casual conversation they were having. And then he immediately moved on without actually making the request. When that person was asked, he said that he didn't even think Trump was serious. He thought he was speaking in hyperbole like he often does, as then he quickly changed the subject, and he never went through the motions of formally actually requesting these troops in any way, shape, or form. And then when the riots were happening on Capitol grounds, where he had the authority to call in the guard and stop it, he sat back for 3 hours drinking a Diet Coke, instead trying to pressure people to go along with his election scheme, while his family and those in his administration begged him to do something, begged him to just call off your dogs, please. When finally, after one person had directly died, another was trampled so hard that she died the next day, officers were injured, where 3 died shortly after this event, he posted it to Twitter and everyone instantly left. I mean, this is just on its face a lie. He's again trying to shift the accountability onto anyone but himself. And the only person who should be prosecuted for all the people who stormed the Capitol should be prosecuted and have been prosecuted. He's talking about 3 of them and calling them patriots. And yet he doesn't mention anyone who's been arrested at a Black Lives Matter rally. I mean, it's not hypocrisy though, right? But the only person in the government who should be prosecuted for it is Donald Trump. And he already is. And he's crying to the Supreme Court for immunity and will likely pardon himself if he wins.